new features in RealityCapture 1.1.1 Blaze. Hello, my name is Tomáš and I want to show you new features in the latest release of RealityCapture. Let's start with something that was requested the most: open and modify PPI projects on different PCs. You can now open a PPI locked project on a different computer and RealityCapture account. Just save the project with the license dataset and upload it to your online storage, so you can continue to work on the project from home. Then you can save the project and send it to another 6 colleagues, so they can open it and make changes to the same PPI project. In total, you can reopen and save the PPI project using up to 8 different computers. Just make sure that only one of the computers is using the PPI project at the same time. Autosave mode. This feature is great for recovering the project back to previous state when an unexpected consequence has happened. You can restore already placed GCPs, computed models, textures, etc. and be back on track. In order to enable it, go to Application Settings and select Yes on Autosave mode. When you will make any change to the project, RealityCapture creates an autosave file located in the project folder with a 30-second delay. Then just launch the project again, click on Recover, and look, all my changes are back. Please read more about autosave in our help section. Continue in model reconstruction. There is one more enhancement to autosave. While you are processing a model, model parts are also autosaved. So when something unpredictable happens during reconstruction process, you can reopen the project, recover the last changes, and continue in model reconstruction where the session has ended previously. We don't need to start from scratch. This can save your precious time when RealityCapture was interrupted and easily continue in model reconstruction. Headless mode for command line interface. Now it's possible to run the application without the main user interface by using a command headless. It will also take less hardware resources because there is no need to render the data live. And this is how the CLI command looks like. Now let me execute the bat file, and as you can see, there is no user interface. In this mode, the app shows an icon in the system tray. The icon also indicates its state. If it's blue, it means RealityCapture is processing. If it's yellow, processing is paused. And if it's red, there has an error message appeared. This small number in the icon corresponds to an instance in which is RealityCapture opened. By left-clicking on the RealityCapture icon in the system tray, you can return to the UI mode by selecting Show App. If you want to hide the UI mode, click on the Show App again. Also, one more thing, headless mode can create a great synergy with the silent command, so the app will be minimized in the tray and all dialog prompts will be suppressed. Please head to our help section to read more about it and how to use it. Changes and improvements to texture layers. Your custom image layer inputs can be imported with a custom name. To have a better organization with the image layers, you can give each layer its own name. The name can be defined by the folder's name, or alternatively, each image can adopt its own image layer suffix. To learn more about separators and how you can use this feature, please head to our help section. Another change is to texturing settings. Now you can select which input layer will be used for coloring and texturing in texturing settings. You can choose to create textures from geometry layer, select one of the texturing layers 1 to 3 or custom names as I have, or you can choose to create textures for all texturing layers. Additionally, you can view and rename the name of the texture layer, see its format, type, resolution, texture count, texturing style, input layer, texturing time, and for reprojected textures you can also see the source model and source texture layer. Some of these settings were previously stored in the model section, but now they are moved here. Graphical user interface scaling, RealityCapture workspace zoom. For those who have higher resolution screens, we have a new zoom function for the workspace part of the user interface. This will enhance the user experience for you if you need to read the text more efficiently. If you select the use window setting option, even the upper ribbon will be scaled according to window scaling setting. Transfer classification from a label layer. Now you can import your classes from classified images as label layers to RealityCapture. The best thing about this solution is that your classified images do not need to be 100% precise and you can use a simpler classificator. RealityCapture will automatically enhance the correct and final classification and you can also do it manually with selections. In the meshing process, moving subjects will be automatically filtered. This way you can classify trees, cars, moving subjects and filter them out with selecting the class. Just keep in mind this feature is experimental. And for the other minor changes and improvements, multiple 2DS views in one layout. You can now change your layout according to your liking. You can use several 2DS views at once, which can look like this. So that's it for the features. There are many bug fixes and improvements that weren't mentioned in the video. So download Reality Capture now and try all these new features. I'm Tomáš and thank you for staying with me to the end of this video. Please follow us on our Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and LinkedIn.